We are gathered here to attend the first session of UPSC Civil Services Examination Optional Economics discussion. Today's topic is demand for money, which in fact very broader topic, and many economists are attached to demand for money. J.M. Keynes, 1936, he popularized demand for money. J.M. Keynes, 1936, book is The General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money. He popularized demand for money in a more scientific way. He said that demand for money means L1 plus L2 is equal to L. Demand for money is equal to L1 plus L2 is equal to 1. That is called Keynesian demand for money. But before Keynes, there was also talk about demand for money, like L1, by Irving Fisher, demand for money for transaction purpose. L1, same L1, which Keynes put into one, by Marshall, Pigou. That is, cash balance demand for money. Demand for money for precautionary motive. Actually, Keynes summarized Fisherian, Marshallian, Pigouvian, and his own Keynesian, and has given an equation L1 plus L2 is equal to L. L means demand for money. L means liquidity preference. J.R. Hicks, Nobel Prize winner economist, when he received the Nobel Prize, in his lecture, he declared that it is J.M. Keynes who had brought liquidity preference term in economics. According to J.R. Hicks, liquidity preference term is invented by Keynes in economics. Liquidity is term of physics, but he brought it into economics, and he utilized in such a lucid way that it has become liquidity preference, and liquidity termed as cash, holding cash. Holding cash is liquidity. What is liquidity? Cash. What is liquidity preference? Desire to hold cash. Desire to hold cash. So demand for money is most important theory in microeconomics, as well as it is applied in macroeconomics, because macroeconomics also takes money. It is question of money. So at graduation level you will read in microeconomics, but in a higher level you will read in macroeconomics. Keynes said that money is demanded for three motives. Keynes was very much fond of writing motives. In previous class, Mr. Amit, I have discussed 8 motives.
Yes, sir.
Have you got it?
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, motive of foresightness. Motive.
Come here. J.M. Keynes was very much fond of motive.
Yes, sir.
He summarized 8 motives for consumption. Summarize? Look at the 8 motives.
Motive for foresight. Motive for economy. Motive for enterprises. Motive of prices. Motive of independence, motive of calculations, and
आपको याद है आपको मोटिव क्या?
नहीं छह अर्थ दूंगी बात नहीं
था। देखिए याद करने के लिए कमांड दीजिए अपने ब्रेन को, है ना? ऐसे पॉलिटिशियंस का कमांड दे दिया, मोदी मोदी राहुल राहुल करता है ना, कमांड है उसके दिमाग में, दूसरा कुछ नहीं बोलेगा, कुछ होगा तो यही बोलेगा। हम लोग इकोनॉमिक्स बोलेंगे, वी आर नॉट कंसर्न विथ पॉलिटिक्स। देर आर 8 मोटिव्स फॉर आवर कंजम्पशन, फॉर आवर सेविंग, 8 मोटिव्स। मोटिव ऑफ फॉरसाइटेडनेस, दैट मीन्स यू फोरसी दैट इन फ्यूचर यू हैव टू face many liabilities, then you save some money. Motive of pride, you want to have a good house, good car, better ambience, you save money for that. That is motive for pride. Motive of independence, if you save and you have money, you will work independently, not dependent on anyone. So this is third. Number fourth is motive of calculation, that you should not spend abruptly without thinking anything. You spend your own stock of money. No, you will think twice before you spend. That is called motive of calculation, that you will design to spend less and get more benefit. Then motive for precautions, that there are many unforeseen reasons, unforeseen events like fire in the house, like accident in the car in which you are driving, like earthquake, like loot by robbers, or such type of thing which happen in Sri Lanka nowadays. Sudden things. You are in a hotel and you will face such a thing that you have lost your leg, lost your hand because of the blast. So uncertainties prevail in our life, which will save you money. For that you want to save some money. For that you want to restrain consumption. Because we know that if we consume more, we will save less. If we save more, consume less. But we will have an optimum relation between consumption and savings. So that we will have some capital formation in your own lifetime. Motive of avarice.
Lalach.
Avarice means greed.
Greed.
And you control it, then you can save. So all these 8 motives were cited by Keynes for saving and consumption. Or desire to save or desire to consume. Now, in demand for money, Keynes has cited 3 motives. Write down number 1 motive. Number 1 motive. Transaction motive. Transaction motive, demand for money. Transaction motive, demand for money. Number 2 motive, precautionary motive, demand for money. Transaction motive, he had borrowed from Irving Fisher. Transaction motive, you write down there, Fisher had said in 1911. Precautionary motive, Pigou has said in 1919.
Fisher
said in 1911. And Pigou said in precautionary motive, Pigou said in 1919. And Keynes, the speculative motive, 1936. He added this 1936 a speculative motive. But what he said, that first two is clubbed into L1. First two clubbed in L1. And third one is L2. L1 plus L2 becomes liquidity preference demand for money. Demand for money is known as liquidity preference. Liquidity preference is known for demand for money. Both are same thing. What is liquidity preference?
Desire to hold cash.
Desire to hold cash is liquidity preference. And desire is the first term in demand. What is demand? First you must have desire. Desire for money.
Purchasing power also.
I'm talking about money, not commodity. In commodity also, you are right. That when we talk about commodity market demand, number one is desire. Number two is
capacity to buy.
Monetary capacity to buy. Number three, willingness to spend that money. Because you are guided by motive of calculation. बहुत आदमी कोका कोला पीने जाता है अगर फंड उसके पास है इंडिया में तो पी लिया नहीं रहा तो बोतल निकलवा के देखा छुआ हाथ उड़ा फिर देख
हाथ ठंडा हो जाता
बट व्हेन आई वाज इन कनाडा इन ऑलमोस्ट ऑल रेस्टोरेंट कोका कोला वाज फ्री एंड वाटर व्हिच वी टेक वाटर 150 रुपीज फ्रॉम इंडियन वैल्यू 150 रुपीज फॉर 1 लीटर वाटर And Coca-Cola as much as you can. I was not knowing, then one glass Coca-Cola was there and finger chips is coming. I have taken whole glass. My son said, why are you taking whole glass? He will again fill it up. Just I saw, waiter came and filled it. Full. Now my belly is 30% filled by Coca-Cola. So there, Coca-Cola is free and water is 150 rupees per 1 liter. I have taken photograph and I have posted in Facebook also that this is the difference between India and the Canada. That in India, Coca-Cola is very costly. You buy it, then you get it. And its price is in India 10 rupees per 1/2 liter. 1 liter.
Half liter, 200 ml.
It means how much price will you 1000 ml?
50
rupees. So costly, but there you can get 1 liter or 150 rupees.
Cooling charge then? In Canada there is no cooling charge. But here there is a cooling charge, sir.
Cooling charge?
Yeah, sir. There is very cold weather that. In Canada, sir?
Yeah.
But here I have to pay.
But they never keep it in cold weather. -40. They are not going to keep Coca-Cola at -40. It will go underground.
Yes.
Their prices is spread in such a way that not to talk about the Coca-Cola, the charges from the beer. In Canada, I have seen that beer is manufactured in the hotel under the glass. You see that your beer is manufactured and fresh beer you will get in the restaurant. Likewise, here you have seen pakora in your food. You can eat it, that pakora is being prepared for you. Likewise, in Canada, I saw beer is prepared like a machine plant is there in the glass is there, you can see that it's moving, and then on the one side for beer, suppose grapes are there, and grapes are used to manufacture it. Grapes are there, they put into that comes, and then the last thing gets in here, and it comes to your devil. But in our country, beer is still considered to be not to be taken by anyone. It is not a general practice to have. In our country, liquidity preference means desire to cash. In developed country also, liquidity preference means desire to cash. There are first reason for transaction motive, that you transact. What is transaction motive? Transaction motive means people desire to keep cash for day-to-day transactions. Suppose you are a student and you are coming from your house to the college, you will have some money to pay to your transport charges, to hotel charges, restaurant charges. So some amount of money you always keep in your pocket. You cannot go empty pocket to your college. You will put some cash. That is for transaction purpose. Keynes explicitly mentioned that transaction term is very important. And he has divided transaction motive into two motives further. Number one, income motive. Number two, business motive. Number one, transaction motive is divided into income motive and business motive. What is income motive? That people desire to hold cash because he will get salary after 1 month. In India, in USA, Canada, they will get salary after 50 days. Your salary is fortnightly. In India, salary is monthly. But there is another payment that is hired labor. Every day they will get payment. So every day he will get money after work. That is called Bihari Mazdoor in Hindi. And daily work, daily wage earner. So three types of people. One get money after 24 hours, another get money after 15 days, and another get money after 30 days. Accordingly, they will plan to keep cash for transaction purposes. Transactions related to purchase of vegetable, purchase of milk, purchase of cake, purchase of pastry, purchase of soft drink. So they will try to keep for 15 days in USA, in our country for 30 days. Your salary will come after 30 days. But in Indian context, it will be the period of motive for transaction, keeping holding money for 30 days. In USA, people will keep money for 15 days. And your daily wage earner will keep money for 1 day.
Sir, is there any advantage for if you change our system from 30 days to 15 days?
Why to change?
Sir, if India changes the transaction motive 30 days from 30 days to 15 days.
So do you want that India can change it or not? That is your question.
China has advantage or disadvantage?
I mean, what do you want?
Actually,
India
has
30
days,
sir.
So, India
has an advantage, sir? Advantage is that you will have your money for 30 days. You are doing work like that. When will you pay payment?
30
days. So, you are doing work, you are not paying payment. That's why you are a permanent worker. You are not temporary or casual worker. Casual worker may get 15 days because they are not part of regular. So whether your post is permanent or temporary, that is very important matter. But method of payment is 15 days in USA because there everything is systematic. And on 15 days you will get your salary credited in your bank. But in our country, large number of people are non-formal. They are no salary. They work without salary. Known as Vitt Rahit colleges. Teachers are not paid. You are talking about 15 days payment. They are not paid even in a year. So the case of India is matter of research for those living in developed country. They will say, why do they work? Why don't you leave their job where they are not getting money? No. In India, there was a bonded labor. Besides, Indira Gandhi released them. Bonded labor means your forefather had taken money from our family. You will have to work and you will leave it. Backside of my house, work my daily work, use, see my cattle, you work in my field, and they were treated as family worker. In their marriages, they invest money. Such type of bondage were there, because their forefather had taken money, and they could not repay their bonded family. So these are the things which are here just now, and that was in USA in 1860, when there was slavery system in USA. This is 2019, I'm talking about 1860, in USA, who is wealthy? Person who has a large land. Person with a large number of animals, person with a large number of black bonded labor, slave. There was slavery system in USA. If you read the history of USA, you will find that India is in that state.
Right now, sir.
Yeah, bullock cart is going. Bullock cart is going in the night and lantern is fixed upside down in USA in 1860. And still in our India, in most of the remote villages, in the night they have to come to their station, they will use bullock cart and lantern inside is used. Of course, there is a torch. There is other mobile torch, everyone has. So these are the stages of development. Every country worked hard to become rich, to become developed. If you are not, your country is not, individually responsible. Not the government, individually responsible. This is not myself saying. This is said by Milton Friedman. Milton Friedman, Nobel Prize winner economist. He said that responsibility to poor is most important thing for the government. But the most important thing is that you are responsible for becoming poor. Not giving attention to your world, reading in the schools. Their quality of education is poor. Not paying food grains to your children and taking thara and become very happy father. You are responsible for poverty, not others. This statement is given by Milton Friedman, Nobel Prize winner economist, when one American student asked that what is the responsibility of the government to poor? Poverty in USA. Poverty in USA was discussed and said that many Americans are poor. Their poverty and our poverty is different. Their poverty that they have car, but old model car. Not fast, not as efficient as a new car. They have poverty that they are living in a house, 5 persons, their rooms are 2. And in our case, poverty is different, that they are not getting food for whole day. They are not having cloth to wear. Their students are not being taught in school. Their disease are not to be covered by insurance. Such type of things are there. But essentially and gradually, it is removing all these hurdles when the stage of development increases. But coming to our main focus point, the transaction motive is taken for keeping money for transaction motive is due to two another motive, income motive and business motive. One individual keep cash for which motive? For income motive. Because he thinks that his income will be after 15 days in USA, Canada, after 30 days in India, and the hired labor or wage earner every day, he will get wage. So how many days you will keep cash for transaction purpose, it is your design that you 30 days, normally in Indian case 30 days people keep, in developed country they may keep for 15 days. Another motive is business motive. What is business motive? What is business motive? Businessman always like to have some cash to pay the transporter, to pay the raw material, to pay the sudden breakdown of any machinery and get it repaired. So they always keep some cash to meet the business needs. So these are the two factors. But can say that demand for transaction motive, demand for money is constant. It is a constant item. It is not a problematic. Every student knows that in his pocket 10 rupees, 20 rupees are there, 50 rupees are there, enough for going and up down and some snacks and some tea. They cannot keep 1,000 rupees in their pocket to attract pickpocketer come and cut. Pickpocketer means? So that I have 1,000 rupees. Now in India, 1,000 rupees is not there. 2,000 rupees. The pickpocketer will sit beside you and he will try throughout. And he is also related to you. You don't know that he is a pickpocketer. You said, coming to your house, to that fellow, your friend or related person, that I had taken 2,000 rupees in my pocket, quite visible, but there is no pickpocket throughout the bus. He laughed. He asked, why you have laughed? He said that your money is fake money, nakli note. I have taken it two times and put it into your pocket. So everyone keeps some money, either for individual for income motive and businessman for business motive. This is first point and this is L1. Again, can say second motive is motive, precautionary motive. This precautionary motive is also used by him, motive of precaution. Motive of precaution. Where? In conjunction function. So he said that motive of precautionary motive demand for money means in every society, people will keep some money as an idle cash balance with him, as a ready money. When there is some occurrence of accident, some occurrence of war, fire, occurrence of any, so he will utilize that money. It is idle cash balance. It is ready money, kept for any event which may occur, uncertain event. There is not certainty.
Hard
time, sir. This is called sudden uncertain events. People keep money for sudden. Uncertain events. Again can say that this is also known as L1 and it will be constant. This is also known as L1 and this is constant. Third item is demand for money for chance, speculative motive. The term a speculative motive is very important. A speculative motive means people, investors, entrepreneur, enterprise, they will invest today to get profit in future. They invest today to get profit in future. So they speculate that the price of X commodity is going to be high. He will hold some X commodity. And for that he will use that money which he keeps with him. So people in the society keep money for a speculative motive. What is a speculative motive? A speculative motive means buying of shares of different companies with a hope that they will be gainer after 1 year. So for 1 year he will wait. If his speculation is true, he will be benefited. If his speculation is wrong, he will be at loss. So this is a case of a speculative motive demand for money. People keep a speculative motive demand for money to get more income in future by investing in the present. This is the behavior of speculators. We have two types of person. One is transactor. One is
transactor.
Transaction motive, transactor. Precautionary motive is also transactor. Keeping money for precaution. When there is some event, he will make transaction. So actually the society can have divided people into two categories, transactor and a speculator. And both demand money for different reasons. But speculators demand money to get more income in future. Speculators will take a loan from the bank, keep cash, loan from the bank and keep cash with a purpose to buy shares. Suddenly, if he thinks that the price is lowest, he will buy. In future, he will sell it. So buying and selling of shares, buying and selling of equities, buying and selling of stocks, these are the reason to keep demand for money a speculative motive. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, my topic is to criticize Mr. Keynes. My topic is today to criticize Mr. Keynes, which he has said. Keynes had given in 1936 and his theory became very popular. But in 1952, William J. Palmore, and in 1956, Tobin, two international economists have attacked transaction motive, L1. What is the reasoning? Keynes said that L1 is constant. L1 is
constant.
And L1 is not related to interest rate. Write down. What is attack? Bamol, William J. Bamol, and Tobin. Put year in bracket. William J. Bamol in 1952 and James Tobin. In 1956, both challenged L1 of Keynes. What was the challenge? Bamol said that Keynes says that L1 is interest inelastic. Write down. can say that L1 is interest inelastic, no relation with interest rate. L1 is interest inelastic. Higher the interest rate, lower the interest rate, L1 is constant. Write down, higher the interest rate, lower the interest rate, but L1 is constant. No effect of interest rate variations. No effect of interest rate variation on L1. No interest rate variation effect upon L1. This was the Keynesian hypothesis that L1 is constant and L1 is guided by income, not by interest rate. This was criticized by William J. Baumol in 1956, and James Tobin, William J. Baumol in 1952, and James Tobin in 1956. Baumol said that Keynes had not imagined ATM. Keynes had not imagined ATM, that don't put money in a bank.
Keynes has not imagined
ATM's facility. Development of ATM in banking system. ATM समझते हैं ना? Account. पैसा ATM में रहता है कि account में रहता है?
Account
में interest मिलता है कि नहीं?
मिलता
है. Why to keep cash in with your bag or in your pocket?
Bank में.
Account में. Account
में.
Everywhere, cinema or you take money in there. And deposit money. But by the
credit
card also you can get petrol, you can get cinema, you can get food, everything you can get by card.
Yeah.
The money is in the bank. Transaction motive money is in the bank. In the night you are sleeping for 8 hours. Money is in the bank. And money is earning money. More. If there is a high interest rate, transaction motive cash will always be remain in bank and he will withdraw at the time of disposal, that he has taken food and then the card. Rest money is in the bank. Keynes thought that people will keep 1,000 in his house to meet day-to-day requirements. Actually, this happened also when there was no ATM, no card. Housewife keeps cash for whole of the month to pay vegetable vendor, to pay milk booth, to pay transport charges. Every time she puts money from her purse and give it to the vendors. Har aurat apne batua mein cash rakha karti thi, rakhti hai. Aajkal jitna jyada developed hai wahan ATM hai, bahut jyada ATM hai. Jahan ja rahe hain kaam ke liye wahan ATM hai, paani nikal ke denge. Aur ab ATM, Paytm, all these development in our country. What to talk of USA? In our country, vegetable wala.